And now, live from the White House, Ask President Carter.
Good evening and welcome to number 10 in the CBS radio series, Ask President Carter, a continuing experiment in presidential communication with the American people. Mr. President, our first call this week comes from Mrs. Edward Hobrat, or maybe it's Hobrat.
That's Horbath.
Mrs. Edward Horbath, excuse me, of Maple Trace, Kansas.
Hello, Mrs. Horbath.
Hello, Mr. President. How are you today?
Very fine. Could you turn your radio down, please?
Oh, yes.
Mrs. Horbath, do you have a question for the president?
Yes, sir. I'm an employee of the U.S. Postal Service in Kansas. Mm-hmm. Last year, they installed an automated letter sorting system called the Marvex 3000 here in our branch.
Yes.
But the system doesn't work too good. Letters keep getting clogged in the first level sorting grid. Is there anything that can be done about this?
Well, Mrs. Horbath, Vice President Mondale and myself were just talking about the Marvex 3000 this morning, as a matter of fact. I do have a suggestion. You know the caliper post on the first grid sliding armature?
Yes.
Okay, there's a three-digit setting there where the post and the armature meet. Now, when the system was installed, the angle of cross-slide was put at a maximum setting of 1. If you reset it at the 3 mark like it says in the assembly instructions, I think you'll solve any clogging problems in the machine.
Oh, thanks, Mr. President. By the way, I think you're doing a great job.
Looks like you've been doing your homework, Mr. President. I'd like to take this opportunity to say that none of these calls are screened, that the people of America are talking directly with the president. Our next call comes from a man who calls himself Dr. Midnight.
Hello, Dr. Midnight.
Is Rosalind there? I really like her.
All right, sir, thank you very much for calling. Thank you for calling.
Midnight, you stupid mother...
Nice one, Mr. President. Our next call is Peter Elton of Westbrook, Oregon, who I am told is 17 years of age.
Hello? Hello?
Yeah. Hello? Hello, Peter?
Is this the president?
Yes, it is.
Do you have a question for the president?
I took some acid. I'm afraid to leave my apartment, and I can't wear any clothes. And the ceiling is dripping, and,
Well, thank you very much for calling, sir. Please.
No, just a minute, Walter. This guy's in trouble. I think I better try to talk him down. Peter?
Yeah.
Peter, what did the acid look like?
They were these little orange pills.
Were they barrel shaped?
Yes.
Okay, right. You did some orange sunshine, Peter.
Very good of you to know about this, sir.
How long ago did you take it, Peter?
I don't know. I can't read my watch.
All right, Peter, now just listen. Everything's going to be fine. You're very high right now. You'll probably be that way for about 5 more hours. Try taking some vitamin B complex, vitamin C complex. If you have a beer, go ahead and drink it.
Okay.
Just remember, you're a living organism on this planet, and you're very safe. You've just taken a heavy drug. Now, just relax, stay inside, and listen to some music, okay?
Yeah.
Do you have any Allman Brothers?
Yeah, I do, sir. Everything's okay, huh, Jimmy?
It sure is, Peter. You know, I'm against drug use myself, but I'm not going to lay that on you right now. Just mellow out the best you can, okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Well done, Mr. President. Bravo.
Walter, I'll call Peter back on Monday to see if he got down okay.
Well, we have one more phone call. The final phone call from Mr. John Smith of San Luis Obispo, California.
Hello, John.
Hello, Mr. President. I just wanted to say that I think you're doing a great job.
Thank you very much.
I myself was employed at the White House for several years during the Nixon administration.
Yes?
And while I was working there, I forgot something on the premises.
Yes, what was it?
Well, you know the Franklin Delano Roosevelt chest of drawers in your bedroom?
Yes, I do.
Check the bottom drawer. You'll find an envelope taped to the bottom. There's several $1,000 in small bills in it. Please send it to me, John Smith, care of General Delivery, San Clemente, California.
I surely will. Thank you.
Well, thank you, Mr. President. Our time is up for this week, but let me remind you that it is now time to buy your tickets for the first American I Slept at the White House lottery on sale at federal office buildings everywhere.
I figure there's no harm in trying, Walter. The tickets are only $1, and maybe somebody out there will win an all-expense-paid trip to spend a night with us here in Washington. Good night.
Good night. Thank you very much.